failure, Brian, right, as they're about to jettison that first stage, you have to remember that everything that is happening in a rocket at that time is at the very edge of what we consider engineering capabilities. And it doesn't take much of a weak link to cause what you saw just there. Incredible dynamic forces, a lot of speed, a lot of pressure on the structure itself. And there will be plenty of information on the ground right now indicating what the possible failures might be. A rocket has a huge amount of telemetry, amount of data that is coming down to the ground as it rises to orbit, and so I'm sure they'll be able to figure this out pretty quickly, but it's a big setback for the International Space Station program for sure.
And perhaps for SpaceX as well. You know, I'm talking to CNN's Rachel Crane over email. She has been studying and covering the SpaceX missions for a long time, as have you, Miles. And she pointed out to me, SpaceX has a perfect record on these cargo missions until today.
This is their seventh official supply mission, actually eighth flight to the station. They had a test run, and the first failure. They've had minor problems along the way, but basically a flawless campaign to the International Space Station. It's been an extraordinary run, frankly, given that this was a brand new rocket design built by SpaceX. Elon Musk, the CEO, almost entirely all the parts and supplies and design done in one factory in Southern California. It's been an extraordinary campaign and an extraordinary run, and getting to space is not easy. Frankly, a lot of us were surprised that they got this far without a serious failure.
The most remarkable thing I've seen in the past few minutes as people process this terrible moment, thankfully an unmanned mission, but a very sad piece of video to see, it was a tweet from Scott Kelly, one of the astronauts who was on board the International Space Station. He had said earlier this morning that he was watching this liftoff from the space station. And then after this happened, he followed up and wrote, "It sadly failed." He wrote, "Space is hard." Three simple words that express exactly what you're saying, Miles, that we sometimes take for granted just how hard this can be.
We do tend to take it for granted, and especially when you've had a run of seven or eight successful launches, you think you've got this thing licked, but it is unforgiving of even the smallest mistake or the smallest failure point. You know, Scott Kelly's in the midst of a one-year flight on the International Space Station to test a lot of things about endurance in space, which will put NASA in a position it hopes someday to send people to Mars. You know, the concern, of course, immediately is, well, are there enough supplies up there for them? And NASA assures us things would not become critical until as late as September, and there are additional flights in between now and then, including a new Russian Progress flight that is going up the latter part of this week. So we'll be definitely holding our breath during that launch.
So, in other words, this is not something that is going to create problems for the space station in the short term. You're saying that this is not something where the supplies needed to arrive this week.
Yeah, they build a lot of contingency in because what happened today is something that everybody expects will happen eventually, frankly. It's it being rocket science. And so there's a tremendous amount of backup supplies and capability on the station so they don't have to get on the Soyuz rockets and abandon ship by any stretch. So there is capability there. We don't have to worry about the crew at the moment. We do have to, you know, spend some time figuring out what happened. SpaceX won't be flying for a little while they try to figure this out for sure. But there still are other ways to get to the space station.
This rocket was carrying over 2 tons of cargo, including a new piece of hardware for the space station. So future space taxis could dock with the space station. Tell us about the taxis.
Well, that's the thing. There was an additional docking ring which they were going to attach, which would make it easier to attach more vehicles to the station. Again, that's not a life or death situation. It's just about making it easier, sort of an air traffic control problem, place a taxi and keep the aircraft to come visit. So they'll have to build a new docking ring and put it on a future mission. That plan will be delayed somewhat, but again, not critical to the health and well-being of the crew. It's not easy getting supplies to and from the space station. Never has been, and up to this point, SpaceX and Elon Musk has had an extraordinary run.